index does not indicate any inflation, but, and one of the causes, one of the results of that is being on Social Security. Anybody on Social Security never got a COLA or an increase in their Social Security. And it's getting disastrous. And if we keep spending and borrowing money like we're doing from foreign powers, I don't know what the future is going to be.
Take a look at the people who moved out of New York State in the past decade. By and large, they are middle to upper middle class, just retired, and wanting to get more value for their dollar. We're losing those people out of the state.
And they're going, he's absolutely right. Here's the problem, it's called taxing. The more taxing, the larger the beast, you keep feeding the beast. And the only way you're listening to it right now, you're listening to it, is soda tax. I really, there might be some people in this room that are in favor of a soda tax. They think you're going to deal with obesity and diabetes. It is really what it is. It's a tax. There's nothing along with, we would love to deal with diabetes and we'd love to deal with obesity. It's soda today, it's the hamburgers and milkshakes tomorrow. It's just about finding another way of taxing us. They're talking about a 0.25% stock transfer tax. People think Wall Street, no, they can afford to do that. And they'll never go anywhere because they got the word New York Stock Exchange on the wall. Well, I guess we all heard about the New York Giants, New York Jets, Brooklyn Dodgers. People, when they get taxed, you don't need New York to be the financial capital. That can move anywhere. We got to be very careful on how we tax. It's about stop spending. And if we stop the spending, we won't need the taxes. The reason the cost of living is as high as it is because of the mandates that we put on government. The government puts on the local governments that pass it on to you. And that's what drives up the cost of living here in the city and state of New York. The only way you're going to bring that cost of living down is to bring costs down and to bring spending down. That's the way you have to do it.
We're coming next, and then we break.
My question concerns the hydro frame on the note that you said that's definitely one of the paradoxes that we all face right now, is that we need these services, but the costs are becoming prohibitive. But you know, from the legislative perspective, legislators that are afraid to say no to people. I mean, there's a lot of people here, they need senior centers, they want skateboard parks and all these things, but these things cost money. I know you don't want to say no to any of your constituents, but somebody just has to say, as Nancy Reagan said, just say no, we can't afford some of these things right now, and we have to cut the expenses somewhere. Most importantly, out of all the concerns that I have, is with respect to this hydrocracking and this water table issue. I can't comprehend the devastation that would happen if there was a problem. We're seeing it right in front of our eyes right now with what's going on off the coast of Louisiana, where this leak that was supposedly a minor thing is much more serious than it turns out to be. And the entire fishing business industry down in Louisiana may be threatened because of this, as in addition to the recreational industries and everything else. It's incomprehensible. And God forbid if they ever did the hydrofracking and we had some kind of an accident that affected our water table in the city. You want to talk about expenses, what it would cost to get water to the people down here or try to refurbish the system. It would be incomprehensible. So I think that, isn't that something, Senator, that would be a legislative thing if you guys, especially the downstate, legislators just said, no way, we can't let this happen. Let's push it off to the back corner. Let's get some legislation which is prohibitive within our water table area.
The answer is yes, and I have no problem in saying no. As a matter of fact, if people don't say no, it's time to throw them out of office. I don't care if the Democrats, Republicans, conservatives, or independents. The object of the game is that people across the city, state, and across this nation are fed up. You don't make a change now, you're never going to make it. Now is the time to take a stand. Now is the time to get the legislators are going to do what they say they're going to do and hold them to it, and they're not doing it, throw them out of office. Shelley Silver has already come out and said that he doesn't want to, not in favor of the hydroflagging around anywhere near the water table. I have no problem in signing any pieces of bill that's going to be part of that bill. Do I believe Dr. Platten is probably coming to, Brandon, his buff is coming to the state of New York? I do. I believe you're going to see it in the future. I believe there is no other alternatives unless we start to look at nuclear. And I'm going to look into this crowd. Everybody's going to look at me nuclear. Nuclear is how Europe does it. And nuclear is something that we do here. But we don't talk about it. Nuclear is something that you'll see this country starting to move towards, if in fact, in the years to come, if in fact we cannot do through the other means of windmill, of water, and other means of energy. But the answer of no is, I believe, and will follow through with that in terms of hydrofracking around our water system. Want to have a question back here, then I have to come back up here to Greg. Then I'll come back to you, which will be the first lady, then I'll get
it. Hi, Con Edison and Partners and Customers is one of the electric supply companies. On the bill, it's always noticed. It's my understanding that Con Edison is not allowed by the state to make a profit on electric supply, only on delivery. A lot of these electric supply companies, though, they are allowed to make a profit on the supply. A lot of them are out of state. Now, it's my understanding also that the out-of-state companies are not regulated by the Public Service Commission. A company called Accent Energy from Ohio several years ago, they tricked me, they called me up and said, well, we can get you a better deal on your electric supply. But they didn't tell me who they were, I couldn't do Con Edison. I can't say they didn't overcharge me, it was a competitive price. It was the same as Con Edison, pretty much, maybe a penny cheaper. But I felt very uncomfortable about getting my electric supply from a company out of state that's not regulated, but it's New York State Public Service Commission. I wanted them to switch me back to Con Edison. They dragged their feet, they stalled me, they delayed me. I had to make a formal complaint to the Public Service Commission, and I got to switch back to Con Edison. So the question is there any risk with these out of state ESCOs? And if they're not regulated, what's to prevent them from charging whatever they want after they make the encouragement to sign a contract?
There's always a risk. There's always a risk. Because it's a competitive environment. They're competing with other ESCOs and they want your business. So they'll make promises to you. Hopefully they'll be honest and tell you the truth.
They can't force you to go back. Yes and no. They can't use practices that would be dishonest to get you to go over to their service. And if you decide to leave that service and go back to Con Edison, they can't stop dragging feet. You can notify PSC, you can notify us. We can stop, even though it's an out-of-state deliverer services, they still have to be transmitted to the Con Edison lines. So Con Edison owns the lines.
If there's a risk, urging the customers to go there, very strongly encouraging
them
on the literature.
Well, one of the reasons why we actually pushed that, it was mandated to push it. Back in the 90s, when the company was told to divest, we had to make a choice whether we wanted to be in the generating business or the wires and pipe business. We chose to stay in the wires and pipes, which is the infrastructure here in New York. Those other companies came in, they bought our power plants, and they run those. So we no longer have any in-city generation. Those ESCOs that you're talking about, before you go to one of those, I would encourage you to do some research. If it's a company that generates their own electric, right, they're one of those generating companies, they're probably a good bet. Some of the ESCO companies will go out, similar to anybody else can do it, you can go out and you can sign a contract with some generating company. You're going to buy so much electric every year from them, and then you can pass it on to other customers, which is what some of them do. Now, that's great as long as that company stays in business, but they're just, some ESCO companies are really just the middleman, so they're passing it on to you. So if you buy it from them, there is a risk. If they overextend their contracts and what they're purchasing at, now they have to go out and buy emergency contracts from somebody to fill the gap because they really don't generate electricity. It's always going to be, you know, a little bit of a risk if you go with somebody who doesn't generate their own electricity.
Con Edison cannot make a profit on the supply.
No, but what happens is if you buy from out of state, in order to get it here, you have to go through everybody else's system. It has to go through what they call the transmission system, the transmission grid. There's nobody that's going to let you go into their system